So you had a question on Bitcoin?
Yeah.
What was your question?
My question was, how does it work? Is it real money? Like, you buy, like, can you go to a store, buy a candy with it, or how does it work?
Right. Well, you definitely can go to the store and buy candy with it, for sure. You know, with Bitcoin is simply a digital currency, right? So it's a currency, meaning that you can use it just like your regular dollar. And I think you were telling me you're from Venezuela, right?
Yes, sir.
What type of fiat do you guys use there?
Bolivares. Bolivares. Right now, they're not even having any over there.
So it's getting devalued over there, or right, it's really bad in terms of the economic situation over there in terms of money?
They usually use sell.
Sell. Is that like an app or something
like
that?
That's an app, like you could transfer money and other. Obviously, I know what we're talking about. It's like a money exchange that you can make money through it, right?
Mm-hmm.
With stocks, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. So it's just another platform that you guys have, and you're probably already used to it with getting stocks and stuff of that nature.
Well,
so
there's no interest rate. There's no money. If the money that you got in there, you sell and you just transfer money, and that's it.
Oh, but it's just more like peer to peer, just the people, almost like a Cash App here,
right,
or
like
something
a Cash
like
App,
that.
Yes.
Or Venmo, or something like
yes,
that.
That's
okay.
What it is.
All right. Well, guess what? I mean, just the same concept in terms of peer to peer. You have the same concept with Bitcoin, right? In terms of peer to peer, from person to person, right? But the thing is you have no third party who's in between us. So with that sell, that's a third party that goes in between me and you. I'm trying to send you money with sell. I have to go through that app, right?
Right.
And that app can pretty much shut down, or they can stop you from sending money to somebody.
They have a limit, yes, they have a limit.
Right? For instance, right, you have a limit, right? With Bitcoin, it's unlimited and it's instant, and the fees are pretty much, you know, very, very, very small, depending on, you can send $1 million to somebody in Bitcoin in the next few seconds, and it may only cost you a couple of dollars just to do that transaction, right? And that person could be over in the next part of the world. Now, your thing is,
Is it legal or illegal?
It is absolutely legal, right? So you've heard a lot of people maybe talking about scams or stuff like that with Bitcoin and stuff like that. The scam itself is illegal, right? The currency is not illegal. So Bitcoin is simply a decentralized currency, meaning nobody owns it, nobody controls it, right? Nobody can stop you from using it, right? How you use it is whether or not if you use it legally or illegally. You understand what I mean?
Okay.
So it's just money. So instead of using, for instance, a Venmo or a Zelle or a Cash App or anything of that nature, you can use several different independent wallets that you own and control. And you can send that money to somebody else who has their own independent wallet or Bitcoin wallet. You understand? So for instance, if you have a bank account, right? How many times have you ever had a bank account and you try to buy something with it and they cut you off from your own debit card, right? Or just like you said, you might have limits, or you might not be able to send that money because the site is down for that day or something of that nature, right? With Bitcoin, you can't shut it down, right? So that's one of the benefits. And you know, I've been living off of cryptocurrency for years, and that's one of the ways that I do. I have a debit card where I can just put my Bitcoin on the debit card and spend it in any store that wants to in the world. So you can definitely buy anything that you want to at any time. The question is how you get Bitcoin, you know? Once you have Bitcoin, you can use it by sending it to the people or just buying anything online or inside of a regular store.
Question.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say we use dollars here, right?
Mm-hmm.
So my question is, if we use dollars, does Bitcoin turn it into dollars, or it has another sign for crypto, for Bitcoin?
Okay, so what you're doing is, the best way for me to explain this is, you know, when you go into a different country, right? I forgot, what's the name of the currency that you have again?
Bolivares.
So when you go to Venezuela, and like me as a tourist, I would need to go to the exchange booth and exchange my US dollars for your currency, correct?
Right.
That's always generally how it works, right? Or I can maybe go to a local bank here and try to get a currency exchange there or something of that nature, right?
Right.
So it's the exact same thing with cryptocurrency. You just need to go to an online exchange and exchange your whatever currency you have at that moment for the exact same amount equivalent in Bitcoin. Right.
I mean, obviously, dollars are worth more than other current money from other countries.
Correct.
Right. Is Bitcoin bigger than dollar or the same as a dollar?
Okay.
In currency money.
In currency. So it is the equivalent, right? So what I mean by that is the equivalent. So let's just say your Bolivian is worth $1, right? And a US dollar, for instance, is worth $10, right? It doesn't matter at what time because it's based off of that same rate at that time, right? So if I have $10 and I want $10 in Bitcoin at that particular time, I'm going to get $10 worth of Bitcoin because I'm simply exchanging. If I have $1 in your Bolivian, then I'm going to get just $1 in Bitcoin at that time. I'm not trading a US dollar against a, you know, Bolivian in terms of that type of trading. No, I'm exchanging my money for Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies.
So Bitcoin is worth the same as a dollar.
So Bitcoin is not worth as much in terms of the same, but you can exchange the exact same value for Bitcoin. So right now, for instance, Bitcoin is dipping a little bit right now. It's about $40,000, right, for one Bitcoin, which means if you had $40,000 right now in US dollars, you can buy one single Bitcoin, okay? That's how much it costs for one Bitcoin.
So but one Bitcoin will be $40,000.
Correct, for one Bitcoin. So what that means is that when you buy that one Bitcoin, you can hold that Bitcoin, or you can sell your Bitcoin, or you can send it to somebody else, right? So if your friend in Venezuela needs $40,000 tomorrow, well, hey friend, I have one Bitcoin, I'll just send you one Bitcoin tomorrow. And now that person has the equivalent of 40,000 US dollars because you bought that at that price in terms of exchange. You understand?
But there's no actual bill for Bitcoins, right?
There's no actual
bill.
Bill?
Like a bill, like paperwork.
Paperwork. No, well, everything is handled digitally online. So it depends on the app that you're using at that time, which will keep records of everything that's happening.
So it's bad if you go to a third world country that doesn't use any apps or it doesn't use any internet and you need the cash, you don't have a Bitcoin currency money.
Right, you're definitely understanding it a little bit, right? If you don't have internet, then you can't use it. You know, that's yes in part, right? But of course, internet is becoming, you know, everywhere. Mostly everybody has a smartphone at least. And just like you said, we're using that cell app and everything like that. So that's not as much as a problem. But where you're seeing it as something very, very good is a lot of people in terms of economic crisis, like you know, don't have access to banks, right? Or they have inflationary rates, or they're not getting enough interest on their money or different things of that nature. So that's why a lot of people really love Bitcoin, or especially in, let's say, third world countries where they don't have access to cash like that, right? So it's very easy for them to transact on the phone. And because of the value of Bitcoin and the potential for it to go up, just like other cryptocurrencies, it is potentially making a lot of people, you know, a lot of money in terms of returns from their cryptocurrencies when they hold it for a long time and the price goes up. And the reason why the price goes up is because there's only a limited amount of Bitcoins that will ever exist. Like with your US dollars and like, just like, you know, in Venezuela, the dollars are getting devalued, right? Region inflation, all of these different things. So when it comes to that, they can print unlimited amount of fiat currency. We know that from this year, from the last year, right?
Right, yeah, they're printing a lot of dollars.
With Bitcoin, there's only a limited supply, and that's why you see the price goes up and down, and over several years, it continues to go up, right? So if you're a person that definitely holds it over several years, you should be okay.
So question, how do you make Bitcoin? How do you make money from Bitcoin? How do you start making money in Bitcoin?
Well, like I said, the very simplest way is to get some Bitcoin, like I said, watch the market, and then when the price goes up, sell it, right? That's the simplest way, right? Just like almost stocks, right? Just the concept like stocks. The reason why people compare it to stocks is because of the price going up and down, up and down. So when you apply that to something like this, where if you get it at a certain price and the potential of it to go up over the next week or the next month, you can sell it at a higher price. Gotcha. Of course, if the price goes down, then you lost money. And a lot of people panic because of fear and they sell it because they think the price is going down and it will always go down. But eventually, it has always proven to go up, you know? So that's how you can simply make money from it. And then making more money from it is your skill, right? I want to get into day trading. I'm an investor. I want to get into, you know, some type of business with cryptocurrency, whether I want to start my own business. I want to accept cryptocurrency as a payment. I can pay you for this ride right now with cash, right? If this was a regular taxi, right? Or I can say, hey, listen, if this was your personal ride, hey, well, you know, let me pay you $10 for this ride in Bitcoin. Just the exact same way. Now you have Bitcoin in your wallet.
Now, who's running this? I mean, you know, government actually take care of their dollar, and they're actually paying attention who's doing this. Like, you can't carry more than $10,000 out of the country. Now, right. You're saying with Bitcoin, you could do whatever you want.
Well, so, it's on your phone. It's on your phone, or it's in your on your cold storage wallet. You know, you have possession of your money now, and that's one of the great things about decentralized, in terms of you can now control your own money. The banks, the government, nobody can tell you what you can do with your money because it's your money.
Which is bad though. I mean, let's put it this way. For example, I could be a drug dealer and put all my money in Bitcoin, and no one could trace me then. If you notice that.
Right. I mean, that's definitely one thing you can do, but you can do the exact same thing with cash. So that doesn't
mean you can't bring cash to another country, because I mean Bitcoin is practically internet, like you said. So let's say I do a deal with drugs, and I can't get my money back because everything is going to be cash, because they're not going to deposit that amount of money in the bank account. So I sell everything in Bitcoin. So I'm getting my money right away from another country. If you realize, that's kind of illegal, isn't it?
No, it's not. Well, the thing is, what you have to remember too, like, let's think about cash. I mean, I can do the exact same thing in cash. I can do it with your cell app. You know what I mean? I can transfer you $50,000 if that was the limit or not. You know what I mean? I can use a different app or any of that type of nature, PayPal, anything of that nature to do any type of transaction that I want that's high. You know, I can do that exact same transaction and mask it in terms of a business transaction. There's so many different things that a criminal can do, right? But when it comes to actual, you know, Bitcoin, you have to remember it's not also anonymous, right? So it can be tracked, you know? That's one of the reasons why criminals really do not use Bitcoin in terms of doing a lot of these illegal things that you're actually thinking. Right, and that's one of the misconceptions with Bitcoin, because you can actually trace transactions. I can see when you move a certain amount of money, and if you identify yourself, I can trace exactly who you are in all of your transactions.
Got it.
You understand? So now, in terms of legalities, in terms of countries and different things of that nature, yes, that could be a problem, but that's also up to you as a person that needs to report your own taxes, right?
Okay, now question, who's backing me up? I know that when you put money in the bank is backing me up in a sense like, I want my money right away, here's your money.
Right.
Either we do it through the bank or you do it cash. Who's backing me up at Bitcoin?
Okay.
Who actually says, okay, if anything happens, I got your back, I got to reimburse your money from where?
Okay.
You get it?
Right, yeah, I definitely get that. So with Bitcoin, of course, right, there's no insurance policy, for instance, right? You know what I mean? It's just like, for instance, like you said, you're holding a dollar and you can possibly go to the bank or go to your government and, you know, have some kind of resolve in that kind of way, right? Now, with the Bitcoin, you know, the powerful thing about it is something called blockchain, where it's basically a public ledger that accounts for all of the money that's out there and all of the transactions, right? So you can trust into this system, right? So it is the system that you're now trusting that allows you to take accountability for your money, or that takes accountability for your money and the transactions that's going on. So the way that it works in terms of how you store money, the way that blockchain records money, is what's giving you the trust in a decentralized way in everybody. Do you follow what I'm saying?
Right. Now, I don't know if you heard, we had a hacker that actually messed up the gas stations here in Miami, here in the United States.
Right.
So we were panicking. We didn't have gas for a certain amount of time. Now let's say we have one of those people that they could play with computer, they could do whatever they want, and they hack Bitcoin.
Mm-hmm.
And you had one Bitcoin, and now you don't have any Bitcoin.
Mm-hmm.
What would happen in that sense?
Well, you have to remember, like, in terms of what happens with hacks, right? Bitcoin itself has never been hacked, ever. Systems in terms of which use Bitcoin has been hacked. Exchanges have been hacked because of their own security practices in protecting the Bitcoin, right? But the Bitcoin itself has never been hacked, and that's one of the powerful things about Bitcoin and why, you know, it's being so popular and gaining so much popularity. right? So when you see about a lot of these different attacks and different things of that nature, they're doing that on other different resources or other different facilities. You can just make a left right here in the grass. Yeah, right here, right in the grass. Yeah. So that's one of the things there that you have to keep in mind when it comes to Bitcoin and the security behind Bitcoin and the encryption behind Bitcoin, which makes it so powerful.
Got you.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Any other questions you have?
No, you're good. You figured everything out.
I did? Yeah. Man, hey, I appreciate you doing this video and I appreciate you dropping me off, man. What's your name?
Juan, bro.
Juan? They call me Black Crypto, so you know, you can tell that I know a whole lot about cryptocurrency. And like I said, I didn't want to tell you anything. I just wanted to really get your reaction
and wanted to find out. Nice.
I think Bitcoin is something that you definitely should get involved with. And if you're sending money to people in Venezuela, you know, this is a really good way to start transferring money and sending money to helping people over there as well, you know? So definitely check it out. All right, and I'm gonna have you check out my channel. I want everybody also to like and subscribe to Black Crypto on YouTube. And I'm out.